Hello everyone, welcome back to this session. So today in this session, we're going to see how we can create an automated CI/CD pipeline in Jenkins using the jobs that we have already created, right? So we've discussed what CI/CD pipelines are, and now let's see what all steps we'll be doing, right? So guys, these are the steps that we will be following. The first step would be to initiate a Git webhook for the Jenkins Git job repository. Right, so basically whatever changes I'm making to Git, that change should trigger the job Git job repository. So let's see how we can do that. Right, so I'll go to my Jenkins workspace, okay, or my Jenkins repository, and what I have to do is I'll have to go to settings. Once I go to settings, I'll click on webhooks. Once I click on webhooks, I'll click on add webhook. Okay, so it needs my password again for this, so I'll confirm the password. And now the URL. So what will be the URL? The URL would be basically this, right? So I'll have to go inside Jenkins URL, which is this, /github-webhook. This you have to write, okay? So once you've specified the IP address, /github-webhook, just click on add webhook, okay? So I'll click on add webhook. And now basically this, whenever the webhook will be triggered, it will give you a green tick over here. So let's check if we can give a push. So yes, so you can see a recent delivery over here. It says a tick mark, which basically means it was successfully basically able to send a request over here on this URL. So we'll just have a look. Once we go to webhooks, you can see there's a tick mark here, which means that everything went fine. Awesome. Now let's come back to our Jenkins dashboard, and basically now what I have to do is I have to trigger the Git job, right? So I click on the Git job, I'll click on configure. Whenever there is a change over there, this basically has to be triggered. So we'll specify this build triggers, and over here you have the option GitHub hook trigger for Git SCM polling. Just specify or just click on this. And that's it, guys. That's all you have to do. Also, now once the Git job is completed, you want to execute another job. So you'll go into post build actions. Okay. So inside post build actions, you have this button called add post build action. Just click on that. And now we want to basically build another project. So what we'll do is I'll search for build another project. Right. So which we have this option, build other projects. Click on this. And we should select the option trigger only if the build is stable. If the build is not stable or it did not complete successfully, this should not be triggered. And what project do I want to build? I basically want to build the build website project, right? So this is the one. I'll select it. So build website is the project that I want to trigger only if this particular job is successful. Now I'll click on save. All right. So my Git job will be completed, and this will basically build my build website job. And now I want, after the build website job, the website test job should be triggered, right? So I'll go inside build website job. I'll click on configure. Okay. I'll scroll a bit down. I'll go to post build actions. Post build actions. Let's add a post build action, which is build other projects. And what project do I want to build? I want to build website-test. This is the job that I want to build, okay? And it should only be triggered if this build is stable, because if my container is not deployed, anyways my testing will fail, right? So I don't want the testing to be executed if this build is not stable. Now I'll click on save. Awesome. So I have successfully specified all the jobs, or I've connected all the jobs. The next step is to basically view them as a pipeline, right? Now for viewing them as a pipeline, just click on the plus that you have over here, new view, right? Just click on that. And over here, as you can see, there are three views that you have right now, list view and my view. There will be a third option, which will be build pipeline view. And in order to get that, what you have to do is click on manage Jenkins, go to manage plugins, right? Click on available and click in the filter, search for build pipeline. Right, this is the plugin that we want to install. Just click on this plugin and click on install without restart. So your plugin has now started to install. Let's wait for it to complete. Awesome. So my plugin has successfully been installed. Now once I go back to the dashboard, now when I click on plus, you can see there's a build pipeline view now. Just click on the build pipeline view and let's call it first hyphen CI/CD pipeline. Okay, we'll click on OK. And now we have the name, we have the description. Now what we have to specify is, this we have to specify, select the initial job, right? So the initial job will be Git job. This is what is being triggered, right, by my Git webhook. So this is going to be my first job. This basically, when finishes successfully, it will trigger the build website job, which when successfully finishes, it will trigger the test website job. This we have already specified, right? So you'll specify the select initial job over here, and that's it. That's all you have to specify. We'll click on OK now. Okay. So you can see that you have your pipeline like this, right? So you have a Git job first, then you have your build website, and then you have your website test. Okay. Now this has to execute. So this is the pipeline which has got created. Now, because the Git job will only get triggered when you have committed the code to GitHub. Now let me show you an awesome thing, guys. So what I'll do, I'll just clear the screen over here, exit the sudo mode. So I am inside the website Git directory, right? Now what I'll do, I'll just do a nano on index.html. Okay. Let's add an h3 as well. This is h2. Let's add h3, and I will say these changes are being deployed automatically, right? And I'll close the h3. I'll save this file. If I check the Git status, you can see there is a modified index.html. So we'll push this to our GitHub. So git add dot git commit hyphen m, and the job will be changed website. We have committed it, and now let's push it to our GitHub. So the credentials are these. All right, so my commit has been pushed. Now you will see that automatically this job will get triggered, right? So let's click on enable auto refresh. So as you can see, this job is automatically started now, right? So this has completed. Now this build website will start. So this will start automatically. As you can see, this also has started. This has completed. And now my website test will start. So as you can see, my website test is being executed, and my website test has also completed successfully. So all three green cards means that your pipeline has executed successfully. Now we can check this. So what we'll do, we'll just go to our EC2 management console, go to the slave. Let's open the website. Can you see these changes are being deployed automatically? Automatically, all your changes were deployed, right? Now, if I again want to do, I'll just close Jenkins now. I don't want to see Jenkins. I'll close my GitHub also. Now imagine yourself to be a developer. Now all you have to do is just clear the screen, do a nano on index.html. Say I again want to add something, right? So say I add one more h3, and I say over here, this is another change that I want to check. Okay, so we'll close it, we'll save the file, right? We'll add the file to GitHub. We'll now do a git commit, changing one more time. Okay, this is a syntax error. So changing one more time, it has been committed. Now let's push this. Git push origin master. The username is this, the password is this. So now my code has been pushed, right? Now let's wait for like 5 seconds. My Jenkins already in the background. I don't have to go to Jenkins to check anything. Already in the background, it has executed everything now, right? So let's wait for some time, and then we'll try to refresh and see if our changes are being reflected over here. So if I do a refresh right now, awesome. So I can see that these changes have been automatically been pushed over here. All I did was I pushed on my GitHub. Jenkins automatically got the change. It basically downloaded the code, dockerized the code, deployed it, tested everything, and then this is what I see, right? So guys, this is how you create an automated CI/CD pipeline. This is automated because you're not going to Jenkins anymore. You're just changing your code and everything is being displayed over here automatically, right? So congratulations on your first CI/CD pipeline. And with this, guys, we have come to an end of our session. So thank you guys for attending this module. I hope you learned something new in this module. Now, in our next module, we'll be talking about Kubernetes, which is module 9, right? So see you in our next session, guys. Have a great day ahead and goodbye.